Well, there comes a time in the construction of a chameleon sailing dinghy where you must literally saw it in half. And that time is now. Oh my goodness, that's harder than I thought it was gonna be. Alright, this is the last little piece.
Something's not right.
So, despite my literally sawing the dinghy in half, it is still one piece. And I can't figure out why. Is that it? Is it loose?
I think so. Was it the
Oh, we got two pieces. Yay! All right. There's some one of those wire stitches down there stuck in the middle somewhere. It is two individual pieces, meow. Okay, so this is definitely a milestone. This is the day we carved the dinghy in half. Let's see how many hours I have into this project so far. Let's see, 15 times 1, 2, oh, 15 times 9. Crap. So I'm up to 139 hours to get this thing built and cut in half. Now I have made a little more progress than that. I've got, I've got the dagger board and the rudder over there just about completely built. I've got this foredeck here just about built, and I have the, oh man, epoxy is drying on this thing. Don't need that laying on the ground. Oh no. Oh no. Oh yuck. There you go. Alright. And I have the dagger board trunk just about built as well. So, you know, made a lot more progress than that in 139 hours, but there we go. We're gonna do something real quick. I haven't actually tested how these pieces of dinghy fit together. Not at all. So let's see how well the pieces nest. Just like that. Alright. That is sort of how the pieces fit together. I hate to be modifying this thing, but I kind of have something I want to change. I'm kind of thinking about making these knees right here shorter. You know? Kind of a smaller support right there so that this can slide on back, because the further this slides back, the more this drops down inside here. I like that. Boy, that's actually a pretty small package. That's what she said. Let's see what the height is on this thing real quick. That is about 21 to the very top right there. Made a small modification to these knees here. Just basically cut about maybe an inch and a half off. And that let this piece slide back just a little bit. 18 inches instead of 21 inches. So that was saved 3 inches of height by chopping off those little corners in there. And I think that's worth it. Now I am to the part where I need to install this daggerboard trunk into the bow section of the boat. Now, you know, you're looking at the bow section upside down, and to try to make this as confusing as possible for you, I'll show you how this mounts also upside down. So it goes like this. Now this this daggerboard trunk, if you see, it's open on the bottom and the back, and it mounts kind of like that up in there. So basically what I have to do before I install this daggerboard trunk is to cut a slot along the back side of this bulkhead all the way down to this beam, and cut a slot up here, which is, this is basically the bottom of the boat, 13 inches long. All right, there is the dagger board slot. That's the piece that came out of it. Boy, that is a huge hole in the bottom of my boat. All right, I've got the dagger board trunk all trimmed up. And it'll fit together just like that. All right, so I have some bad news. I made a rather severe error, you know, in my construction so far of the dinghy, and it's specifically concerning that daggerboard trunk. Now, this, the daggerboard trunk is completely epoxied into place, and I, you know, set it right there based on measurements that I took from the corners. And it's actually tilted a little bit this way at the top. You can see it better if I put the daggerboard in place, so check this out. Surely you can see how the top part here is leaning over that way just a little bit. Now, this is this is the stupid thing about it. You know, this problem is something that, I mean, it really wouldn't affect how the thing sails or anything like that at all. However, I think that if I left it like this, it would just bother me every single day that I look at this. It's probably leaning over maybe 1 degree or yeah, probably not even 2 degrees, but I don't think I can leave it like that. I don't know. I can almost hear you saying, you know, leave the stupid thing alone. It's not worth the trouble, but I cannot live with myself if I don't undo this thing and correct this angle. Here we go, disassembling the daggerboard trunk. Well, the heat gun seems to be working. However, it's putting off some crazy fumes as it's heating up that epoxy. And as I'm sure you know, I really don't have that many brain cells to spare. So, safety first. Okay, George, if I got to pay here, So I just about got the daggerboard thing released from the top side. Now I got it. Got to flip this over and release it from the bottom side now. So there's the slot. As you can see, it's just kind of mangled up here. You can see it better from over here. So here's the, so I've got to rebuild all this splintered plywood, all this glass cloth. I want to just get a good kind of before and after going on here. Here's the daggerboard trunk, and there's the mangled slot that it used to sit in. All right, let's see if we can fix this thing. So I've got the daggerboard trunk basically ground down. I just took all of the loose stuff off of it. Now this looks gnarly as heck, with all the splinters and things like that have been removed from it. So it's really not as bad as it looks, I don't think. It's gonna look ugly, you know, fit in there, but once everything is filled back in with epoxy and fared out, I think it's gonna look pretty good. Okay, all right, I think I finally got this thing in position. I've spent like half an hour, like, you know, truing this thing and looking along the line, going under here and checking if it's vertical and coming up here and knocking it around and checking the line and going down here and coming out here and checking the line and going down here. And finally, I think I have it where I like it. Looking pretty darn good, and this stagger board is basically holding that that trunk in the position I want it in. So yeah, all right, so now I'm kind of repairing this bottom side here, and now I gotta fill all these other voids out here. That one, the one under this temporary board, and this one right here is the one I'm about to fill right now. Alright, now I'm just gonna let that cure. And then I'll take off those two temporary boards and do this ugly area, and then I'll do this ugly area down here. So yeah, just fixing all this damage that I caused right now. But it's gonna look good. You just wait and see. All right, well, there you have it, the dagger.
Get up to 35% off.
There you have it, the dagger board trunk has been reinstalled in all these horrible, nasty places that I created by removing the thing have been repaired, filled with thickened epoxy. Here's what the underside looks like. It is upside down in this picture, but you get the idea, I'm sure. Got the epoxy fillets in there, and everything looks pretty darn good. And yeah, this reinstallation process of this thing did take a solid 20 hours, but you know, I've had the dagger board back in there, and it is lined up perfectly, and I am satisfied with the repair, so it is worth it. I'm gonna go get some more.